In a previous video, I tested some grab adhesive using a jig like this, using some wooden blocks. I then used some hydraulic test equipment to see how much force was required to remove each block. A couple of people weren't happy with the outcome, and one particular adhesive manufacturer got in touch and said that a much fairer test would be to use stainless steel. So I've gone to the trouble of cutting some stainless steel blocks like so, and I've actually got about 12 of those, and then I've got some stainless steel which has been screwed down here. So I'm going to repeat the test using stainless steel. Before I stick down the blocks, I'm going to clean each piece of stainless using methylated spirit. I'm also going to clean the plate that it is going to be stuck down to. So I've got some methylated spirit in a sprayer. I'm now going to spray this onto all the stainless. I'm going to clean it all thoroughly before we repeat the test using the stainless steel. I'm going to start at this end and then I'm going to glue each one of the stainless steel pieces all the way down the front of this sheet stainless steel. I've cut all the nozzles so they are approximately all the same size. That should roughly give us the same size bead, but it does of course depend on the viscosity of the adhesive. So I'm going to start off at this end and the first one we're going to use is GEOCELL The Works. I'm now going to turn that over. I'm going to ensure that I place that where there is no screw. I'm going to press it down on the edge there and I'm going to apply a firm pressure. I'm now going to take a marker and I'm going to write on the stainless steel exactly what it is. This has been left for over 1 week for the adhesive to cure fully. I'm now going to start off at this end. I'm going to start off with the CT1. We're going to see how much hydraulic pressure it takes to remove the piece of stainless steel from the stainless steel plate. As you can see, that did not even hold as well as the wood, which I tried in the first test. The adhesive is still not dry on that, and that has actually been in the house for over a week. So it wasn't actually my idea to test this out on stainless steel. This was actually suggested to me as a test. So I was happy to oblige. I've done the test with stainless steel, and it doesn't seem to be as good a test as what it was when I used the timber. We'll now try the serious stuff. Now the no more nails. That one just did not stick at all. Now the UNIBOND mega grip. Again, that's not stuck at all. This is quite a surprising test actually, because a lot of these adhesives do say that they can be used on metal, which is a very vague term. They don't actually tell you which metals they do work on. Now, Adiseal. Now the sticks like shit. Now Nemesis. Now the maximum torque. Now the SOUDAL fix all. And finally, GEOCELL the works. I've actually done this test using stainless steel because somebody suggested it. They were not happy with the way I did the first test using blocks of wood. I have actually tried to do this test using some galvanised steel, and the metal didn't stick at all very well. So this time I used a stainless steel sheet and stainless steel pieces like so. I went to a great deal of trouble cleaning them, sticking them down, and then these have actually been left in the house with the central heating on for over a week. And you can see that some of the adhesive still has not gone off, and the ones that did go off, they did not do a fantastic job of holding the stainless steel. So you do have to be careful. When the manufacturers say that grab adhesives can stick metal, Yes, they can, but they don't do it brilliantly. And most of the grab adhesives do work a lot better on other substrates, such as concrete and such as wood. I'd like to thank you for watching this video. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel.